All right, we're back for another day of the Spelunky Daily Challenge. I had a pretty good time yesterday, had some people in the chat, but today is Sunday, so I'm just gonna go pretty much right into things, see how I can do. I'm showered, I'm reinvigorated. Again, this is Alex from The Impact Factor. It's a blog, theimpactfactor.blogspot.com, a podcast, which is right here on this YouTube headstone playlist even, or soundcloud.com/theimpactfactor. It's two scientists talking, video games. So, all right, so I ended up 144th. That's actually lower than I thought I'd get, with a pretty decent score of 100,000. I made it halfway, through the ice cave, so that's good. I'm glad that they're, on top of things and doing well. Maybe I should be a little bit more on top of things. All right. One of these days I'll choose a different damsel for you guys, but I'm still feeling yellow today. Yellow's my default. If I recall correctly, too, she's an unlockable damsel. A lot of the damsels, actually, you have to unlock. A lot of the player characters you have to unlock. You can, some of them you can find in stages. Some of them require specific tasks. So it's fun. It's fun having that process of, unlocking a different person you can play as. And some of them are pretty hard. I don't know if you saw, there's this kind of old-looking guy wearing white. His name is Yang. And you get him from beating hell, so if nothing else, you can scroll through your character screen and you can have people see he did this, he has Van Helsing, I see he's beaten Black Castle or whatever, he's gotten to the top of the Undead Castle. So I did something kind of special for you guys today too, so keep an eye out for damsel and damsel noises. There's something that was added in a Spelunky update, which is pretty great. I mean, this is an old update. I usually don't play with this on, but I feel like I should change it up for you guys. Let's trigger this trap. Oh, what's that sound? That's not a normal damsel sound. There we have it! The sloth damsel. Sloth, because, I don't know, it felt like having a sloth. The way you get it is by going to the options screen and selecting the pug as your damsel, 100 times, and that's not even an exaggeration. You have to select him back and forth. Probably 100 times. and then eventually, he'll transform into the sloth. I thought he might fall down. And then you have a sloth unlocked on your whole playthrough. Or in your whole play session, so not even just this run, but if I were to do another run after this, I'd have the sloth again too. But the thing is, after you quit out of the game, the sloth goes away, so you have to go back into the options every single time you start up a new game of Spelunky to get the sloth. So here, I'm just gonna buy the bombs. Spike shoes are nice, but I want to save some money. And a shotgun, it's always so tempting to buy, but... I thought I could get both bats. But, eventually I hope to get one, somewhere on the black market at the latest, so I'm not gonna go for that. I'm having a pretty great weekend so far, so hopefully this Spelunky run can close it up well. Get to hell, beat old man, something like that, that'd be nice. Get most of the way through Persona 4 Golden, which is just, it's just an incredible, fun, memorable game. I'm 75 hours deep into this game. It's ridiculous. It's caused me some problems, right? I have a blog where I write new game reviews and try to keep abreast all the new game content for you guys, and here I am sinking 3 days plus of pure gameplay into Persona, but it's worth it. It's been a game I've been meaning to play for a long time, but never really had the facilities. I didn't really want to play the PS2 version, just because, I don't know, a lot of those PS2 version, a lot of those PS2 era JRPGs really date themselves. I don't even know why I'm trying to trigger that. And, I heard Persona 4 Golden's the definitive version of Persona 4, so... But then, Justine got me a Vita for our 4-year anniversary, and with it, Persona 4, so that's been great. It's been fun playing with her, too, because, we're kind of invested in the characters, and want to see what happens next. So I'm going to use this scorpion to trigger the trap, because it's satisfying to see him explode. Just gotta be on the lookout for the eye. I still haven't seen that. Ooh, welcome, second viewer. Now here's... Here is the eye. In stages where you have, like, sections of the level blocked off, it always makes me nervous. Because that, like, the eye will be behind one of those things. Ooh, ooh. But we're doing alright. One of the advantages of carrying the damsel around through the level 2, which I really haven't gone into before, is if you were to accidentally, like, trigger... Ugh. Gosh. If you were to accidentally trigger an arrow trap, the damsel will eat the arrow for you. So it's, like, great. Well, at least it doesn't look like the eye is up there, so, hey. And we have 5 health, so I... Gosh. Yeah, I'm gonna sacrifice the damsel. Ooh, paste. I love paste. As I was talking with my co-host of our podcast, Fliss, Charles Fliss, Fliss of the North Star, paste is one of those items that I always, always, always like to have. It's one of those things you don't think that it has a great impact until you get to, like, the temple or the jungle and you don't have paste. Or, you know, the temple or the ice caves and you don't have paste. Then you just feel bad. So paste, you know, it's like any kind of bomb you want to get, especially if you want to kill, like, Anubis. Gotta have that paste. This is kind of annoying. I didn't really have anything to bring to the next level. I don't see any shopkeepers here, though. Oh, gosh. So this is a huge risk. Oh, man. So I just felt like getting a little extra money. So, yeah, that's... For anyone who is asking, that's what happens... Ooh, okay, so now good. We didn't miss it. That's what happens when you grab the idol head on the caves. Giant rock comes out and just starts destroying everything. Alright, just want to make sure the key wasn't this way. That spider's trying to get me. Oh, I'm like, why is the caveman not moving? He wasn't moving because he was stuck behind wall. Ugh. So I really just hope the golden key isn't in that spiderville here. Oh, there it is. Ooh, thank God. So, now that I have paste, they'll make that easy to blow up. It'll only require one bomb to get to this key here. Let's see which way the spider jumps. Just make sure he doesn't deal a point of damage to me. Again, there's so many ways you can take stupid points of damage. Ugh, like that. I should have looked up. I was too distracted looking at the arrow here. Alright, we're in the jungle. 4 health. 4 health? 4 health. I... Black market would be nice. Ugh. But until that point in time, let's just collect some money. Monkeys. I don't like them. They follow you, they lure you into that false sense of security. It's like, well, they don't do damage to you, right? So, yeah, this, whatever. Until they make you dizzy and then you fall and then you get killed by a tiki trap. Yeah. Alright. It's funny that gems, those tiny little gems can cause damage when they fall. Alright, let's check down, jump on him, so I don't have to deal with that. Trigger the tiki trap, just to make it. And let's get this last little gem. So I didn't see the beeping anywhere, and each level is contained within this giant square, and the, you know, the tiles fill themselves out appropriately. And so, if I feel like I've made a pretty good run of left and right, generally, the level will take you, like leftwards and down, rightwards, leftwards down, rightwards down. So I feel like I've got. But. See if you can get him stabbed. This altar here is good, though. I guess that's the way I need to go. One of the dangers here, though, with that is having the explosive frog trigger Bat's not gonna trick her. Uh-huh. Can those frogs get out? Oh, that's too dangerous. I don't like that. Ah, 2 points of damage. Alright, you can use ropes as weapons. That was a little... I didn't want to use two ropes there, but... Ooh. We're hearing some pinging. That's actually pretty common there. Now, see, this is one of those black market entrances where, like, if you didn't have the... There's no way that if I didn't have... you know, the eye that I would have found that. It was so buried. Oh, well, might as well take this. I've used up enough resources, so let's just move on to the next level. Oh god, I hate when the piranha plants spawn there. Whip them down. Just want to get him out of the way. Is there a bomb somewhere I can buy? Alright, well, it sucks to waste so much money on a bomb box. But I need bombs to fill out the rest of this. Oh, my poor score. What, does he have a message? Oh, a vampire's bite. Alright, well, we got that. Walk this way, he should jump right over me. Alright. I'm not too bad at this game. Oh, teleporters. Man, this level, Black Market really wanted me to have some teleporters. That's dangerous. I saw the shopkeeper already go down here. So, yeah, this makes me nervous. So I'm gonna put a rope down here. I'm gonna blow up this tiki trap. Just makes me nervous knowing that he can get out. Oh, man. Alright, well, he's stuck. Let's do this. Oh gosh. Oh gosh. Lay some fire down. Alright, I see both their guns. It's still really dangerous because the damsel was there! Oh gosh. So they managed to jump up from the bottom. That's super unusual. They were the two shopkeepers in the shop below, and it's highly, highly, highly unusual that they can actually get up to the top, to the middle stage. Ugh, so it's rough. And I guess I didn't collect the Ankh. I thought I had. I guess I was in a rush to kill the shopkeepers. Sorry you're coming a little late to the party. Steven71 Dragon, unfortunately... I ended my run pretty early, so don't let this rank 9 fool you guys. I'm doing my daily challenge a little earlier than normal. so my 67, my measly 67,000 is not gonna keep me in the top 100 even. So that's it. Daily challenge. If you come back to my stream, Steven71 Dragon, we can get some Spelunky going. But until next time, guys, thanks for watching. Let's do a better, more energetic daily challenge tomorrow.